Welcome to this brief guide on how to change the address of your Microsoft account. Most of us already have an existing Microsoft account. Generally speaking, this will be an Outlook.com email address. However, for one reason or another, you may wish to change the email address that you utilize for your Microsoft account. So today, I'm going to show you how you can head to the Microsoft account page and in just a few minutes, switch out the address that is associated with your account without losing any of your data. The first part of the process will be to sign in with your existing Microsoft account. This is important. And just like normal, you'll be prompted to enter in your password and potentially any two-factor authentication should you have it associated with your account. In my case, I'm utilizing a passkey. Now, the key thing to remember here is to not create a separate Microsoft account. Creating this will end up with two accounts and you will not be able to merge them in any way in the future. I cannot stress this part enough. Now, here I am on the Microsoft account homepage. And as you can see, I have my Microsoft account address and this is the part that I want to change. So I no longer want Paul's YouTube demo at outlook.com. I'd like to create a new address. However, my account has some things attached to it, such as a Microsoft 365 family subscription, which then means I also have OneDrive storage that I'm making use of. Migrating that to another account can be a bit of a pain. You may also have something such as an Xbox Game Pass subscription tied to your account as well. So moving all of these is not something we want to do. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to head to the Your Info button in the top left-hand corner. And selecting this is going to bring us over to our account info page. And it's on this page where we'll be able to make changes to things such as our profile photo, our date of birth, or about a third of the way down the page here, we have our account info. This is the section that we'll focus on in this video. Here you can see I have my email address that I use to sign into my Microsoft account. But I'm going to select the option that says Edit Account Info. There is a possibility that you'll be requested to do two-factor authentication in order to get into this section. What you'll also see here now is that I happen to have a single account alias. I have my Paul's YouTube demo at outlook.com. There is a button that says Remove, but selecting this will give me a pop-up notification letting me know that I can't remove this address as it's the only alias that is on my account. So I'll simply select OK. And in order to resolve this, I need to add an email. This is the part where we're going to create a brand new email address. Just by simply entering in our preferred address here, and depending on the region that you're in, you may be able to select the drop-down menu next to the outlook.com, and as you can see, I have a .com.au option as well. You will see that there is an option to add an existing email address as a Microsoft account alias. This is only for use with non-Microsoft account addresses, such as Gmail, etc. I highly recommend not doing this and instead creating a separate Outlook.com address to utilize. This can avoid confusion in the future. Selecting the Add Alias button will add this as a brand new alias for our account, provided no one already has it, which is why it's super critical that we didn't create it separately. Here you can see now we have one last step, and that's to get rid of the alias that we don't want. So in order to be able to remove that, we need to make that new address our primary alias by selecting the Make Primary link. We'll get a pop-up letting us know that we're going to be changing over the primary alias for our account, and just as a confirmation, we'll like us to click the Yes button. Selecting this will then convert over our primary alias for our Microsoft account. The website will then refresh, and in just a couple of moments, you'll see that now the new address that we've just created is now our primary alias. And so we have one last step to do. And you guessed it, that's to remove the address that we no longer want from our account. We can do that by simply clicking on that remove button next to the appropriate address. We'll get a warning letting us know that we're going to remove this alias from our account, which will mean that we will not be able to receive email to this address. So make sure you're not using it in any of your online services before doing so. A key thing to note here is that you will not lose any existing email that was previously sent to the old address. Select the Remove button to complete this process. And in no time at all, you'll see that we only have one alias now. The other one is completely gone from our account. Now, the last thing to do is we can simply head back to our Microsoft account homepage, and you'll notice one little issue here. The old address is still showing at the moment on our page. This can take a few hours before it will show up in other services. However, if you want to sign in to any of your existing services, such as Microsoft 365 or Xbox, you will simply use your brand new address alongside your existing password and any authentication methods, as these will not have changed. And don't forget to sign out of the Microsoft account site, just so you don't have anyone having access to your personal information once you're done. And that is how you quickly and easily change the address associated with your Microsoft account. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.